an introduction.
Education is universally recognized as an important investment in building human capital. It is the key to technical innovation and economic growth. It is the primary duty of the government to provide education to everyone in the country. But there is a wave of privatization of education in our country. Actually, government has directed its focus from higher education to primary education and urged private sector to enter this sector, which is termed as privatization of higher education. Privatization of higher education in India. As economic reforms were introduced in India in 1991, in the past, higher education has been largely a state-funded activity in India. Its total expenditure was being borne by government. But the needs of higher education system have been increasing rapidly, so it is being realized by the government that public budgets cannot accurately fund higher education. The privatization of higher education would reduce the amount spent on higher education by the government. With the privatization of higher education, the budgetary allocation for higher education was decreased. Report of various committees. Government has appointed some committees to study the impact of privatization of education in India. The Punya Committee 1992-1993. The Punya Committee was set up by the UGC. The committee has recommended that as a general rule, universities should generate 15% of its annual maintenance expenditure through internally generated resources, and this should go up to at least 25% at the end of 10 years. Second, Dr. Swaminathan Panel 1992. The Dr. Swaminathan Panel, which was set up by the All India Council for Technical Education, also made important observations on the mobilization of additional resources for technical education in India. The panel had put forth the idea of collecting educational purse from industries and other organizations. Third point, higher education in India, vision and action. The contemporary India HRD Minister Murali Manohar Joshi of BJP stated in the country paper Higher Education in India, Vision and Action on 1998. The government wanted to encourage private initiatives in higher education but not commercialization. Now next one is fourth one, Birla Ambani Report on Privatization of Higher Education 2000. The Prime Minister's Council on Trade and Industry appointed a committee headed by the industrialist Mukesh Ambani and Kumar Mangalam Birla to suggest reform in higher education sector of India. The committee submitted its report in 2001 and the document was entitled A Policy Framework for Reform in Education. Birla Ambani Report on Privatization of Higher Education 2000. The main views and suggestions given by the committee about higher education are given under. First is, the committee considered education as a very profitable market. Second point, the government should conform its to primary education and higher education should be provided by the private sector. Passage of Private University Bill. Now fourth point, reinforcement of the user pay principle in higher education. Fifth point, loan and grants to the economically and socially weaker section of society. Privatization of higher educators. Birla Ambani Committee proposed the enactment of a assembly banning any form of political activity in the campus of university and educational institution. Even the normal trade union activity will not be allowed. Recommendations of Birla Ambani Committee. First point is primary and secondary education. Make primary education compulsory and free. Primary education must be on the top of the education agenda. Secondary education must be compulsory as well. The constitutional commitment to compulsory education for children up to age of the 14 years. Second point, teacher education. Bring about regulations for continuous teacher training and quality upgradation. Third point, sensory learning. Migrate from teaching to sensory learning in preschools and in primary education in order to provoke curiosity. Fourth point, technology. Leverage out waste and growing resources in information technologies to bring out smart schools that integrate computers, networking and content. Fifth point, teachers as facilitators. Emphasize learning through practice and experiences. Transfer teaching role to one of the facilitator. Sixth point is value education. Emphasize value education at pre-primary level and enforce it is primary, secondary and higher education. Seventh point, rating system. Institutionalize a system for periodical rating of all educational institute in India. Common national content. Introduce a common national system for educational content at the school level after providing for regional and local vocations. Decentralization of management. Devolve to the panchayat level financing and management of education at the primary and secondary level as well as literacy programs. Tenth is market oriented education. Encourage school of learning to upgrade content and facility to make them more market oriented. 11th point, common admission testers. Institute a common system for admission to professional courses based on national standardized test on the line of GRE, SET and GMAT. 12th point is private university. Assembly a private university bill to encourage establishment of new private university in the field of science and technology, management and finance area. Now the criticism of the report. There are some points for as well as against this report. Against views, self centeredness. For Birla Ambani, education is a very profitable market over which they have full control, and for their industrial requirements, education must shape adaptable, competitive workers who have readily acquired new skills and innovate. Second point, privatization of higher education. These two industrialists ask for immediate privatization of several segments of education, especially higher education. On the basis of this report, the government has proposed and passed a bill called Private Universities Bill 2003, permitting the setting up of self-financing university. Third is increasing cost of education. Such suggested privatization has seriously affected our society as now. Even in middle classes who earlier have been somewhat benefited from the reservation are given being marginalized due to increasing cost of education. Commercialization of higher education. Ambani Birla report sought to convert the entire system of higher education in the country into the market where profit making is only consideration. For Ambani and Birla, education is a very profitable market over which they must have full control. Fifth point is not good for weaker people. विद सम लाइक प्राइवेटाइजेशन इन हायर एजुकेशन इट विल गेट आउट ऑफ द रीच ऑफ द इकोनॉमिकल वीकर सेक्शन ऑफ द सोसाइटी द दलित्स विल सफर ड्यू टू इट. Privatization of higher education has many advantages in favor view. Quality education. Privatization of higher education will bring in quality education supported by better infrastructural facilities and professional approach to teaching. Second point, greater reach. It will also lead to greater reach to rural area through the online education system in the long run. Third point, wider prospectus. Privatization of higher education will definitely expose the student and teacher to international education standards, thereby showing better opportunity for employment on a global basis. Fourth is need of new market economy. For the new market economy, all over the world is increasingly compiling the universities and other academic institutions to introduce skill-oriented courses which require higher investment but fetch smaller social benefits. Fifth point is stress on primary education. The government will the constitutional obligations to provide free and compulsory education in India has increased the investment in primary education. As a result of which the investment in higher education has proportionately decreased in order to meet the growing needs of the student population for higher education in the country. It is an imperative for the government to private higher education. This is also the view of Ambani Birla Committee. Privatization is now unavoidable. We like it or not, we have to accept it and acquire yourself for change. The state should invoke a policy for funding higher education to SC, ST and poor people so that the gap between the haves and have not should not increase. Thank you for watching.